Lewis, Delaware. Lewis is an incorporated city on the Delaware Bay in eastern Sussex County, Delaware. According to the 2010 census, the population is 2,747. Along with neighboring Rehoboth Beach, Lewis is one of the principal cities of Delaware's rapidly growing Cape region. The city lies within the Salisbury, Maryland-Delaware Metropolitan Statistical Area. Lewis proudly claims to be the first town in the first state. Lewis was the site of the first European settlement in Delaware, a whaling and trading post that Dutch settlers founded on June 3, 1631 and named Swanendael. The colony had a short existence, as a local tribe of Lenape Native Americans wiped out the 32 settlers in 1632. The area remained rather neglected by the Dutch until, under the threat of annexation from the English colony of Maryland, the city of Amsterdam made a grant of land at the Hohenkills to a group of Mennonites for settlement in 1662. A total of 35 men were to be included in the settlement, led by a Peter Cornelis Plockhoy of Zierikzee and funded by a sizable loan from the city to get them established. The settlement was established in 1663, but the timing of the settlement was terrible. In 1664, the English wrested New Netherland from the Dutch, and they had the settlement destroyed with British reports indicating that not even a nail was left there. The area was slow to resettle, but a new settlement gradually regrew around the Hohenkills. In late December 1673, when the area was briefly held again by the Dutch, the settlement was attacked and burned down again by soldiers from the English colony of Maryland. In 1680, under the authority of James Stuart, Duke of York, who had been granted such authority by his brother, King Charles II, the village was reorganized and known for 2 years as New Deal, Deal County, Delaware. A log courthouse was authorized to be built at this time. A Church of England congregation was established by 1681 and a Presbyterian church was built in 1682. In 1682, the Delaware colonies were given to William Penn by English King Charles II in payment of a family debt. When Penn arrived in the New World later that year, he renamed the county as Sussex and the Hohenkills settlement as Lewis, in commemoration of sites back in England. Lewis became and remained the county seat of Sussex County until 1791, when it was moved to a more west-central county location, the current town of Georgetown. On April 5 and 6, 1813, during the War of 1812, British naval vessels led by HMS Poictiers under the command of Captain Sir John Beresford briefly and ineffectually bombarded the town. A cannonball from the bombardment is lodged in the foundation of Cannonball House, which now serves as the town's maritime museum. Lewis was incorporated by an act of the State Assembly on February 2, 1818. The act provided for 5 persons to be chosen as commissioners to be known as trustees of the town of Lewis. Lewis Beach itself was an important stop on the Underground Railroad in the years leading up to the American Civil War. As a border state, Delaware was not part of the Confederacy, but was still quite dangerous for fugitive slaves. Several houses in Lewis thus housed escaping slaves. These safe houses were identified by the residents placing a single candle in the top window of the house. In 1941, the United States built Fort Miles on Cape Henlopen, immediately south of Lewis, to defend Delaware Bay and the Delaware River and the oil refineries and factories on its shores, as well as the city of Philadelphia. It was one of the largest and most heavily armed coastal fortifications ever built. Fort Miles never saw any major action, except for range practice. It fired its guns only once between its establishment and the end of World War II. Fort Miles ceased operation altogether in 1991 and was deeded to the state of Delaware. In addition to Fort Miles, the Cape Henlopen Archaeological District, Coleman House, Cool Spring Presbyterian Church, DeVries Palisade, Delaware Breakwater, and Lewis Harbor, Fisher Homestead, Fisher's Paradise, Colonel David Hall House, Hopkins Covered Bridge Farm, Lewis Historic District, Lewis Presbyterian Church, Lightship Wall 539, Mall House, National Harbor of Refuge and Delaware Breakwater Harbor Historic District, Pagan Creek Dyke, Roosevelt Inlet Shipwreck, William Russell House, St. George's Chapel, Lewis, Townsend Site, and Wolf's Neck Site are listed on the National Register of Historic Places. Six men who served as Delaware governor were born in or made their home in Lewis. Three of the men lived on Lewis 2nd Street. Brothers Daniel and Caleb Rodney, sons of John Rodney, first cousin of Caesar Rodney, each served as governor of Delaware. Each a member of the Federalist Party, Daniel served from 1814 to 1817, while Caleb served as acting governor from 1822 to 1823. Ebe Walters Tunnell moved to Lewis in 1873 to enter the drug and hardware business in part of the old Caleb Rodney house on 2nd Street. Tunnell worked his way up the state government hierarchy before unsuccessfully running for governor in 1892. 4 years later, the Democrat won the election, and served from 1897 to 1901. As Lewis was the earliest settlement in the state, and Delaware was the first state to ratify the Constitution, the town refers to itself as the first town in the first state. Lewis is named after the town of Lewis in England, which is situated in a county named Sussex. Lewis, Sussex, England, also has the same seal. Lewis is located at 38°4628 and 75°0822W/38.77444° and 75.13944° W/38.77444, -75.13944. According to the United States Census Bureau, the city has a total area of 4.3 square miles, of which 3.7 sqmi is land, and 0.6 sqmi is water. Situated on the Atlantic coastal plain, Lewis's weather is moderated by the Atlantic Ocean and the Delaware Bay. Lewis has a mild subtropical climate consisting of hot, humid summers and mild winters. The average daytime high in July is 87°F and a low of 70°F. In January, the average high is 45°F with an average low of 30°F. The month of highest average rainfall is July with 4.78 inches of rain, while February is historically the driest month, receiving an average of only 3.23 inches of rain. The highest official temperature ever recorded in Lewis was 102°F in 1997. The lowest official temperature ever recorded in Lewis was -11°F in 1982. As of the census of 2000, there were 2,932 people, 1,338 households, and 797 families residing in the city. The population density was 801.5 people per square mile. There were 2,368 housing units at an average density of 647.3 per square mile. The racial makeup of the city was 87.31% white, 9.89% African American, 0.14% Native American, 1.02% Asian, 0.03% Pacific Islander, 0.72% from other races, and 0.89% from two or more races. Hispanic or Latino of any race were 1.67% of the population. There were 1,338 households, out of which 15.1% had children under the age of 18 living with them, 49.3% were married couples living together, 8.4% had a female householder with no husband present, and 40.4% were non-families. 35.1% of all households were made up of individuals, and 14.4% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 1.99 and the average family size was 2.53. In the city, the population was spread out with 13.6% under the age of 18, 3.7% from 18 to 24, 18.0% from 25 to 44, 31.5% from 45 to 64, and 33.1% who were 65 years of age or older. The median age was 55 years. For every 100 females, there were 78.2 males. For every 100 females age 18 and over, there were 76.1 males. The median income for a household in the city was $66,387, and the median income for a family was $72,605. Males had a median income of $39,500 versus $35,227 for females. The per capita income for the city was $36,685. About 3.1% of families and 6.0% of the population were below the poverty line, including 11.3% of those under age 18 and 5.4% of those age 65 or over. Lewis is served by the K-Penn Lopen School District. Lewis is home to the University of Delaware's Hugh R. Sharp campus is also within the city. This is home to the university's College of Earth, Ocean, and Environment. Lewis serves as a vacation and resort spot popular with residents of Washington, D.C., and the surrounding suburbs. Even though the city limits primarily sit on the lower reach of the Delaware Bay, it is nonetheless considered an ocean resort, particularly as the ocean is nearby at Cape Henlopen. Lewis is among those communities which have banned smoking in its public parks. Lewis is the home of the Zwanendael Museum, which features exhibits about Delaware's history. Savannah, 2nd, and Front Streets are the town's main streets and have many shops, restaurants, parks and historical venues. Fisherman's Wharf is a dock that stretches along the Lewis and Rehoboth Canal. It features multiple restaurants and bait shops, and in season the dock hosts hundreds of boats from all over. The Lewis Historical Society promotes the preservation, interpretation, and cultural enrichment of the Lewis region through museum exhibits, educational programs, historical research and publications. Lewis in Bloom is an organization that promotes and maintains the beauty of historic Lewis. Lewis in Bloom won America in Bloom's contest in 2003, 2005, 2010 and 2015 for cities with population under 5,000. In 2012 and 2015 Lewis in Bloom was honored in the IBE Circle of Champions. United States Lightship Overfalls, one of 9 surviving lightships at museums in the United States, is moored in Lewis along the Lewis and Rehoboth Canal. Lewis is home to several iconic lighthouses in the Delaware Bay. Just offshore lies the National Harbor of Refuge, which is home to the Delaware Breakwater East End Light and the Harbor of Refuge Light. Lewis is adjacent to Cape Henlopen State Park. Lewis also maintains several parks within the city limits. Dean Rec maintains a boat ramp just outside the city limits along the Broadkill River, adjacent to the Roosevelt Inlet. Delaware Route 1 passes just outside city limits at 5 points where D1, U.S. Route 9, D404, D23 and D1D intersect. There are 3 main arterial roads that connect Lewis to D1, New Road, Savannah Road, and Kings Highway. U.S. 9 passes to the southeast of the city on the Theodore C. Freeman Memorial Highway. Parking meters are in effect for on-street parking and parking lots in the downtown area between May 1 and October 14 and at parking lots at Lewis Beach between May 1 and September 30. The southern terminus of the Cape May Lewis Ferry is located in Lewis. The ferry provides passenger and automobile ferry service between southern Delaware and southern New Jersey, crossing the Delaware Bay to North Cape May, New Jersey, and serves as part of US 9. The ferry crossing is 17 miles long and takes 85 minutes. Cape Water Tours and Taxi operates a round-trip water taxi service between Lewis and Dewey Beach via the Lewis and Rehoboth Canal on Friday evenings in the summer months, offering access to dining and nightlife in Dewey Beach. DART First State operates the Lewis Transit Center Park and Ride just outside Lewis along D1. The transit center serves local bus routes providing service across Sussex County, with expanded beach bus service to the Delaware beaches in the summer months, and inter-county bus service to other part of Delaware. This park and ride serves the Route 201 bus to the Rehoboth Beach Boardwalk, the Route 203 bus to Dewey Beach, the Route 204 bus which heads along Savannah Road into Lewis to Cape Henlopen Drive and the Cape May Lewis Ferry Terminal, and the Route 206 bus to Georgetown. The Route 305 Beach Connection bus provides service on weekends and holidays in the summer to the Lewis Transit Center Park and Ride from Wilmington, the Christiana Mall, Middletown, and Dover, with service continuing south to Rehoboth Beach. The Route 307 bus provides year-round service to Milford and Dover. The Delaware Department of Transportation built the Lewis Transit Center Park and Ride, with groundbreaking taking place on March 9, 2016 and the Park and Ride opening in May 2017. The Delaware River and Bay Authority operates a shuttle bus route in the summer months that connects the Cape May Lewis Ferry to the Tanger Outlets and Rehoboth Beach. Lewis was served by a branch of the Delaware Coast Line Railroad that originated in Georgetown. A rail with trail known as the Lewis to Georgetown Trail opened along the railroad line on October 19, 2016, with future plans to extend the trail to Georgetown. In 2017, it was announced the Delaware Coast Line Railroad would be abandoned between Cool Spring and Lewis after the swing bridge over the Lewis and Rehoboth Canal was closed due to being structurally unsound and repairs were determined to be too costly. The Junction and Breakwater Trail is a rail trail for bicyclists and hikers that connects Lewis and Rehoboth Beach, running 6 miles mostly along a former Penn Central Railroad right-of-way. The Lewis Board of Public Works provides electricity, water, and sewer service to the city. The BPW was established by an act of the Delaware General Assembly on March 15, 1901. Lewis formerly had a power plant that generated electricity for the city, but the plant's usage was reduced as the city brought in power from outside and the plant was shut down in the 1970s due to rising fuel costs. Lewis currently purchases power from Constellation, which is transmitted to the city over Delmarva power lines. The BPW is a member of the Delaware Municipal Electric Corporation. Trash collection is provided by the city while recycling collection is provided under contract by Republic Services. Natural gas service in Lewis is provided by Chesapeake Utilities. BB Healthcare Medical Center is located in Lewis, founded in 1916 by the brothers, Drs. James Beebe and Richard C. Beebe. Because of Beebe Healthcare Medical Center, there is a growing healthcare industry in and around the city. The hospital's name was changed to Beebe Healthcare in 2013, and 2016 marked its 100th anniversary. On August 21, 2013, a helicopter reportedly dumped $10,000 in multiple dollar bill denominations over Lewis Harbor in the fulfillment of a deceased local resident's last wish.